Hey everybody, today I'm having chicken wings, corn, some macaroni salad, and I'm having a green salad with some mushrooms. And Mama Bella's French bread. And for my drink, I'm having Lipton iced tea, peach tea. I haven't tried this before, but I thought it would be delicious. So that's what I'm having today. And I bought some lemon infused water just in case I want it. And the weather is getting very, very hot again. So I feel like I'm sweating already. And I sort of don't want to turn the fan on because it's so noisy, but I think I better. But before we do that, Father God, in the name of Jesus, I praise you for this day. I thank you for this meal. In Jesus' name, I ask that you make it nourishing. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you all for coming in. Having macaroni salad. Green salad, great big giant organic mushrooms. I read that mushrooms are good for hair growth. And I have a question for you guys. Most of you have heard about the famous Housewives of Atlanta. And if you watch it, you will know that Phaedra did some outlandish, outrageous, appalling things. Most notably, to Candy. And I was really, really shocked and appalled when I found out about that. I didn't think she would do something of such magnitude out of jealousy. I held her in much higher regard than someone who would do such a thing. So I was very, very disappointed to find out that she had done that. And I know many people were, but a lot of people were not surprised because they could basically see through the facade of whatever image she tried to portray. But I tried to see the good in her, and I enjoyed her. Her witty sense of humor. I could get a good laugh out of some of the things that she would say. And so I enjoyed her entertainment. But when I found out what she had done to Candy, I said to myself, I'm just so through with her. I'm just so done with her. As if my opinion mattered about it at all. And I thought about Bill Cosby and how it was so controversial whether or not I believed what he had done or not. And so sometimes I would have doubts that he actually did those things. And sometimes I had doubts that some of those ladies were telling lies. And then when Beverly Johnson came out and told her story, I said to myself, I believed her. And now I believe that there's a whole lot of truth in what is being said about this. And so I was saying, she has her own money and her own fame. So what can she gain out of telling such a lie? And somebody's going to come up with a reason why, you know, a reason why she would do it, why she would lie. And somehow I kept believing that it had to be some truth in it. Even if somebody told a little lie or a bigger lie from somebody else, I felt like there was some truth to it. But then when they said that they had gone and taken down a statue that had been erected in his honor, somehow it made me feel bad. And I can't really describe, or I just don't know why I felt so badly when that happened. But I did. But when as soon as I found out corn had no nutritional value, I started tweaking for it. I just had to have, just give me more of it than I need. Just give it to me. But anyway, when I found out what's her name had done to Candy, And I started feeling so much like, I'm so through with her. And nobody cares anyway and whatever. And then, all of a sudden, I said to myself, I should take down that video that I did of her book, The Secrets of the Southern Belle, because I did a book review, and it was a positive book review. And now I just feel like, should I take that video down in her dishonor? Much like they took down that statue. And oh, what a dishonor that is. To have them have erected a statue in your honor. And then take it down. Do you think I should take the video down or just leave it up there? I would like to know your opinion. And why or why not, if you would be kind enough to give me your opinion. When you get jealous, do you let your jealousy take over your actions? Or do you pray about it and try to contain yourself? I know someone who says that she never gets jealous. And I really don't believe it, because I think that everyone at some point or another gets jealous. It may be warranted or it may be silly, but I think we all have jealous tendencies. But what we do with those tendencies is what makes us strong or weak. Do you try to destroy others? Do you try to destroy yourself? Do you pray to God and ask Him to help you with what you're feeling? Do you have techniques that you use to divert your thoughts away from destructive, jealous feelings?
You slash other people's tires. So you tell lies on them. To try to make yourself look better. I use Kroger lemongrass, garlic, chili pepper sauce on the chicken. If you want me to, I'll show you the bottle in a minute. I meant to bring it in here, but I forgot. I need to pick it now. This is it. Private Selection Spicy Lemongrass Marinade, Vietnamese inspired. Just in case. Excuse me, just in case you were interested. Thank you for watching. Mm. Thank you so much for watching.
Bye-bye.